Okay, good morning children. So in the previous class we have completed exercise 3. Now let us go with the next concept, addition of algebraic expressions. Addition of algebraic expressions. So how to add two expressions or two or more expressions, algebraic expressions. See, for addition or subtraction we have two methods, column method or vertical method, row or horizontal method. Two methods we have. So you can use any one method. Okay. Whichever is easy for you, that you can use. In both ways you will get the same answer. Okay. So for that, how to do in vertical method and how to do in horizontal method, that I'll explain. Okay. So for that first step, let us consider one example. So here I have taken one example. Add 5x square plus 9x plus 6. 4x plus 3x square minus 8 and 5 minus 6x. We have to add these three expressions using, first I will explain using vertical method, then I will explain using horizontal method. Okay, on both ways I will explain. So you can use whichever method you want that you can use in solving problems. Okay, so first let me explain using vertical method how to add two or more algebraic expressions using column or vertical method. Vertical method means one below the other we have to write. One below the other we have to write. Horizontal means one after the other we have to write. That's it. So first, in vertical method, how to solve this one? How to add this one? See, what you have to do is first write the first expression. See, it is in standard form. It is in standard form. In decreasing order. See, 2, 1 and 0 or decrease. Decrease on it, decreasing order. So it is in standard form. So first write in the same order. 5x square plus 9x plus 6. Okay. Or you can write this variables also. On the above you can write variables also. Like that also write up or write like this only. Simply write the first expression. In order, if degree, any degree is not there, is missing means just write a 0. Same like in the number system how we have written, same like that only if any position is not there means J we have to write 0. Here they are in order, degree 2, degree 1, degree 0. So they are in order, so write like that. Then go for next expression. Now see, what you have to do is from this expression same degrees must be under same. Same variable and same degree. Okay. Same in addition, how you write units digit under units digit only, you have to write. Same like that only here. See, from this expression, x square term you have to write under x square term. Here x square term is plus 3x square. So I will write here plus 3x square. Under x square you have to write x square term only. Don't write 4x here. Under x square only like terms can be added. So like terms must be one after the other. One below the other must be the like terms only we have to write. See x square. Then we have here x term. So write x term. No sign is here, this is plus only. So plus 4x. Plus 4x. Then constant. What is constant? Minus 8. So minus 8. Okay, x square term, x square term. X term, constant, constant. Second expression is finished. Then go for third expression. See, third expression, do we have x square term? We don't have x square term, so write here 0. When you don't have that term, just write it 0. Then do we have x term here? Yes, what is that x term? Minus 6x. So write here minus 6x. Minus 6x. And then the constant is, before constant no sign is there, means we will consider as plus 5. So write plus 5. Okay. The sign before the term is its sign. Okay. This is minus 6x. Total minus 6x, we have to write here. Minus 6x. Then plus 5. Okay. Under the constant, we have written number. And then x term, we have written x term. Now after this, all the three expressions completed now. Then go for addition. This is plus. Addition of algebraic expressions, no? So we have to add. So while adding, again go for addition. Separator. Term wise. First, these two terms. 5x square plus 3x square. Here plus is 5 plus 3. By adding like terms, what I said? You have to add coefficients. 5 plus 3. 8x square. Same. X square will be same. 8x square. And here, 9 plus 4. 13. 13 minus 6. How much? 7. 13 minus 6 is 7. So, plus 7x. Then go for 6 minus 8. Minus 2. Minus 2 plus 5. Plus 3. So, what is the answer? 8x squared plus 7x plus 3. So, that is the answer for in using vertical method. This is using vertical method. See, in horizontal method also you will get same answer only. But the method is different. Same problem I will do using horizontal method. Okay. Understood this one? What we did? Under the same like terms we have written. Under the. That's it. Same like terms. One after the other we have written. One below the other. Okay. Same like terms. See, x square, x square. X, x, x. Constant, constant, constant. Like that you have to write. And then you should add. Okay. Next up, for horizontal, what you have to do is, same example I'll explain. For horizontal, no need to write down, one after the other. Here, just in a line you have to write. Just simply by keeping in the middle plus. See, first expression, rise, first expression, 5x square plus 9x plus 6. Keep it in the bracket. Now write plus. Why? We are doing addition now. So plus. And then write second expression. 4x plus 3x square minus 6. And then write plus. And then plus expression. 5 minus 6. Okay. Now, remove the brackets. Remove the brackets and write only the terms. 5x square plus 9x plus 6. Yeah, plus is there means the signs will not change. Same signs you will get here. No sign means plus. So all same signs you will get. 4x plus 3x square minus 8. Here again plus is there. So sign will not change. Now write the like terms together as a group. Right? The like terms as a group. Same like in the third term. X is we did. Simplification. Same like the rule. Write like terms in the 5x square. Here x square term, where is another x square term? Yeah, plus 3x square, right here. Plus 3x square. Plus x terms, 9x plus 4x minus 6x plus constant 6 minus 8 plus 5. Now write 5x square plus 8x square, 3x square, 8x square, 9x plus 4x, 9 plus 4, 13, 13 minus 6, 7x, 6 minus 8, minus 2 plus 5, plus 3. Got the same answer. See? Both are same, but the method is different. Okay, so you can use any one method to do the problem. Okay. So this is addition of algebraic expressions. Next I'll explain subtraction of algebraic expressions. Okay, next, subtraction of algebraic expressions in both methods. Vertical method and horizontal method. How to do subtraction. So in the, we have learned about addition. Now we are going to learn about subtraction of algebraic expressions. First step. Let us consider one example. Subtract 4 plus 3m square from 4m square plus 7m minus 3. You know already, whenever they have given subtract one expression from other means, whatever the from they have given, that you have to write first. Okay, so vertical method, write this expression first. 4m square plus 7m minus 3. Okay, under this you have to write the first expression here. From what expression they have given, that you should write first. Then write the remainder. Now, same. Under m square, you have to write m square. 3m square plus 3m square. We know m term is not there, so write it as 0. Then constant is plus 4. Same like addition only you have to write. Now, what is the difference here for addition and subtraction? By doing addition, we have written like this and then we have added directly. But for subtraction, what you have to do is, while doing subtraction, here the signs will change. This down expressions, the signs will change. Plus will become minus, minus will become plus. Here, plus 3x square means this will become minus. And this is minus and this is also minus. Plus will become minus, minus will become plus. Additive inverse. Okay, additive inverse you have to consider. This plus will become minus. Now we have to consider this sign only. While subtracting, first change the signs and then go for subtraction. Okay, whatever the sign under this is there, now that sign only you should consider. Now see, 4 minus 3. Consider 4 minus 3. 4 minus 3 is how much? 1. 1 means simply you can write m square. Next, 7 minus 0 is nothing but 7. So plus 7m. Next, minus 3 minus 4. Minus 3 minus 4. Both are minus. So minus 7. So what is the answer? M square plus 7m minus 7. Okay. This is vertical method. Why doing horizontal method? First, what do you have to do? You have to write the second expression first. 4m square plus 7m minus 3. You should write this under brackets. Now we are subtracting. Addition means we have written plus. Here subtracting, no. So write minus. And then write first expression. 4 plus 3m square. Remember, from which expression is given, that you should write first. See, from 4m square plus 7m minus 3, they are given. So write this expression first. 4m square plus 7m minus 3 minus, then write the next expression. 4 plus 3m square. Okay. Now, remove the brackets. Here, no sign. Before now, bracket no sign is there. That means we should consider it as plus. When you have plus, nothing will change. Same terms you have to write. 4m square plus 7m minus 3. Now, when you have minus here, the signs of the under bracket terms will change. Here, no sign in this is plus. When you have minus outside, the sign will change. Why? Because minus into plus, minus. Minus into plus, again minus. The signs will change. Plus will become minus, minus will become plus. So, change the signs here. Minus 4, minus 3m square. Plus will become minus, minus will become plus. When you have minus outside the bracket, when you have minus outside the bracket, the signs will change. When you have plus outside the bracket, nothing will change. Same signs you will get. When you have minus, reverse signs you will get. Okay. Now, go for writing the like terms together. Write the like terms together. 4m square minus 3m square plus 7m only. One term is there. So 7m, one term only you have to write. Then minus 3 minus 4. Now 4 minus 3, 1. 1 means simply write m square. 1m square is nothing but simply m square. Plus 7m. Minus 3 minus 4. Minus 7. You got same answer. Both ways you got same answer. You should get same answer, otherwise you did something wrong. Whichever way you do, you should get same answer at the end. Okay, this is subtraction of algebraic expressions. Now using this, let me explain exercise 4. Okay. Okay, exercise 4. See here, exercise 4 first bit is homework for you. Add the following algebraic expressions using both horizontal and vertical methods. Did you get the same answer with both methods? You'll get the same answer, obviously. But doing 4, they have given in the first bit, they have given 4 problems. All problems you should do in vertical method as well as in horizontal method. In both methods you have to do same like how I did addition. Okay, so you do all those four problems. Second problem, simplify. See, this is same like horizontal addition. In exercise 3, how we did? Just write the like terms together and then add the coefficients or subtract the coefficients and write the answer. Okay, this is the same like exercise 3. One problem, fifth problem I have explained, same like the room. Okay, next, third problem. Find the perimeter of the following rectangle. This is also same like exercise 3. Find the perimeter of the following rectangle. What is the formula to find the perimeter of a rectangle? Perimeter of a rectangle is 2 into L plus B. See, let me explain this one. They have given one rectangle. 6x plus y, 3x minus 2y. You have to find perimeter. What is the formula to find perimeter of a rectangle? Perimeter of a rectangle is equal to 2 into L plus B. Here, length is given as 6x plus y and breadth is given as 3x minus 2y. Just simply you should substitute those expressions in L and B. Here, 2 into L value is 6x plus y plus B value is 3x minus 2y. Now, write the like terms together. 6x plus 3x plus y minus 2y. Like terms. 6x, 3x like terms. Y and minus 2y are like terms. Same variables. X and x, y, y. Together, I have written. Then go for coefficients. 6 plus 3, 9. So, 9x. 1. Here, no coefficient means it is 1. 1 minus 2. Minus 1, so minus 5. 2 into is there, distributive property. Apply distributive property. 2 into 9x minus y means 2 into 9x. 2 into 9x, 18x minus 2 into 1. 2y. With both terms, you should multiply distributive property. A into B plus C is equal to, B minus C is equal to A into B minus A into C. That means with both terms you should multiply this by 2. 2 into 9x minus 2 into 1. 2y. Okay, so 18x minus 2y. This is perimeter of rectangle. Next problem, fourth term. Find the perimeter of a triangle. Whose sides? Triangle. What is the formula to find perimeter of a triangle? And you know already. What is that? Perimeter of a triangle is equal to sum of its all sides. Sum of its all sides. Just add all the three sides. You'll get the answer. Add them. Keep plus plus in between them. And then write the like terms together. And add them. You'll get the answer. Okay. Next. Fifth bit. Subtract the second expression from the first expression. This I do. One problem I do. Fifth bit. Any one problem I do. Remaining all you have to do. Subtract the second expression from first expression. Which one do you want? Let me go with the last one. 6m cube plus 4m square plus 7m minus 3 comma 3m cube plus 4. 3m cube plus 4. See here. You can do either in vertical method or in horizontal method. What is given? Subtract the second expression from the first expression. From first expression, you have to subtract this one. That means, you should write the first expression first. So, I will use a horizontal method. 6m cube plus 4m square plus 7m minus 3 minus 3m cube plus 4. Right? First expression first. Then minus and then write second expression. Remaining all same like this only. Now remove the brackets. 6m cube plus 4m square plus 7m minus 3. What I said when you have minus outside the bracket, the signs will change. Here, this no sign means it is plus. So the sign will change. This plus will become minus 3m cube. This plus also will become minus 4. Now write like terms together. You have a two like terms here. 6m cube minus 3m cube. M square only one term. So write m square. Then 7m. Then we have minus 3, minus 4. Constants together. Now go for coefficients. 6 minus 3, 3m cube plus 4m square plus 7m minus 3 minus 4 minus 7. So this is fifth bit, seventh problem I have explained now. Now remaining all are homework for you. Okay. Then you have more 4-5 problems are there. Okay. Let me explain sixth problem. Subtract the sum of x square minus 5xy plus 2y square and y square minus 2xy minus 3x square from the sum of another two expressions they are given. First they are given, first you have to find sum of first two expressions, then sum of another two expressions. After that you have to subtract those two. So first I will write sum of x square minus 5xy plus 2y square and y square minus 2xy minus 3x square. Oh, you have to find sum of these two first. So, what do you want? Which method do you want? Shall I go with vertical method? Okay, so x square minus 5xy plus 2y square. Now under this expression you have to write like terms. Okay, from this expression you have to write x square term. What is x square term? Minus 3x square. So minus 3x square. And xy term? Minus 2xy. Then y square plus y square. There no sign means it is plus. Plus y square. So I have written one below the like terms. I have written. Now go for addition. Here no number is given. No coefficient is given. This is 1. 1 minus 3. 1 minus 3 is minus 2. So minus 2 x square. Minus 5 minus 2. Minus 7 xy. 2 plus 1 plus 3 y square. Here no coefficient means it is 1. Okay. So 2 plus 1 plus 3. Now this is 1. Then go for next. Again they have given two more expressions. Again we have to find sum of 6x square minus 8xy minus y square and 2xy minus 2y square minus x square. 2xy minus 2y square minus x square. Okay. This I will do horizontal. Okay. One I will do vertically, one I will do horizontal. If you want, you can go with both vertical or both horizontal. Okay. As you wish. So first write 6x square minus 8xy minus y square. This is addition, no? So directly I am writing addition. So plus 2xy minus 2y square minus x square. By doing addition, the sign will not change. So we can write directly also. Just keep plus and then write all the expression. Now write like terms together. 6x square minus x square. X square term and x square term together. Then minus 8xy plus 2xy. Then minus y square minus 2y square. You get done with that. Like terms, I have written together. 6x square minus x square minus 8xy plus 2xy. Xy, xy terms. Then y square and y square terms. Okay, two terms together I have written. Now solve them. 6 minus 1. Coefficient only now, you have to subtract. 6 minus 1. 5 x square minus 8 plus 2 minus 6 xy minus 1 minus 2 minus 3 y square. So this is sum of these two expressions. What I have given? Subtract first sum from second one. This is we need to subtract 1 from, we need to subtract 1 from 2. That is all we have done. Subtract sum of these two expressions, that is 1 from sum of these two, that is 2. Subtract 1 from 2. 1 from 2. So from is given in which, what you have to write first? Second expression you have to write. So write second expression first. 5 x square minus 6 xy minus 3 y square minus. Which way do you want? Shall I go with vertical method again? I'll go with vertical method. Easy. First, second expression I have written. Then write first expression. Minus 2 x square minus 7 xy plus 3 y square. They are in order. Same. X square, x square. Xy, xy. Y square, y square. Now, this is subtraction, no? While doing subtraction, what is it? You have to change the signs. This minus will become plus. Minus will become plus. Plus will become minus. Now, see, 5 plus 2. This sign only you should consider, not the previous one. After change the sign only you have to consider. 5 plus 2. How much it is? 5 plus 2. 7 x square minus 6 plus 7. Minus 6 plus 7 plus 1, 1 xy minus 3 minus 3 minus 6 y square. So this is the required answer for sixth problem. Okay. So this is sixth problem. More we have a 7th, 8th, 9th and all.